Hi, I'm Dennis, and in this video I will show you how I made this female torso out of plywood using several different kinds of software, my CNC router, and lots of patience. A couple of years ago I made this female torso out of gypsum, and I used this to create the 3D model for the woodworking project. I chose 3/4 inch sandy plywood from Home Depot, as it is made of hardwood with minimal core voids. It may not be grade A, but it's affordable and good enough to get a job done. I needed 4 pieces of approximately 600 millimeter each, so I opted for the 4x8 and had it cut at a store. The actual thickness of this 3/4 inch plywood is 17.8 millimeters, but the top and bottom surface layers are much thinner, and the 5 layers in between span a combined total of about 60 millimeters. Now, since the grain direction of the layers alternates, I plan to remove the 0.9 millimeters on top and bottom, and then rotate the different slices of the model 90 degrees relative to each other, so that when I stack all the slices together, the alternating grain pattern continues throughout the entire statue. I took 50 pictures of the torso from all angles. I then compiled a 3D image of these pictures using Zephyr software. The resulting 3D image required some manual cleaning up to smoothen all the bumps and the holes. Mesh Mixer is the ideal program for that, but it's still quite labor intensive. I also used Mesh Mixer to cut the 3D model into virtual slices of exactly 16 millimeters thick, and rearrange the individual odd and even numbered slices in single planes, so that they all fit on a total of 4 sheets of plywood. Finally, I used V-Carve to create the CNC toolpath and add tabs to hold the pieces in place.
Alright, enough talk. Let's get started.
The maximum distance between the router collet and the bed is 80 millimeters. The thickness of the custom spoil board is 18, and that of the plywood is 17.8. I wanted the dowel holes to go approximately 8 millimeters into the spoil board. Therefore, I should extend the bit about 35 millimeters out of the collet, so that there will be at least 9 millimeters of room for the wood chips to clear. That way, I can use a Z-safe distance of 5 millimeters, which is plenty to stay away from the stock and still have 4 millimeters to spare, so that I don't have to be too precise when installing a router bit. So now I have 4 boards for 14 slices with a total of 24 pieces.
And a bucket full of dust.
I marked their orientation and now I'm going to cut them out. As you can see, I did not yet remove the tabs. I'll do that after I glue them together, so that I can send them off when they're in place and leave a smooth connection from slice to slice. All the pieces are glued together. The glue has dried overnight, so now I can remove the tabs and sand it all down. I'm going to use natural Danish oil to bring out the contrast between the different layers. Alright, that's it. Thank you for watching.
I don't know yet what I'm going to do with it. Maybe I'll just do the master for the world learning application. I don't know.